Let's learn how to insert page numbers in your Pages documents. The easiest way to add page numbers to a document is to insert them in a header or a footer. The header and footer fields are invisible when they're empty, but you can see them when you hover your cursor over them. When I move my cursor over the top of my page, I can see three header fields where I can add page numbers. Personally though, I like to have them at the bottom, so I will hover down below until the three footer fields become visible. If, however, when you hover over the top or bottom, the three fields don't appear, that means your header and footers are turned off for the document. To turn them on, first click the document icon on the right, then select the document tab and make sure the header and footer checkboxes are checked. When I click inside the bottom center field, an insert page number option appears. Another way to insert page numbers is by going to menu, insert page numbers. However, I prefer inserting page numbers directly in the header or footer field because then I have an option of four different numbering styles. Now we have page numbers on all seven pages of our document. Once you have added page numbers, you can change the number style by going to Format at the top, then style it as any other element in your file. I will make it bold, very large, and light blue so that you can easily see all the changes we are going to be making. You can now easily see page numbers on all seven pages of our document. This has been the most straightforward way of numbering pages, but it is not always how things are organized in our documents. The current document that we have here is a word processing file. In Mac Pages, word processing is a file that you use to draft reports, letters, books, while page layout is used to create designs such as flyers, posters, etc. To check which one you have open, click on the document icon in the top right, then under Document tab, see whether the document body is checked. If it is, then you are working with a word processing file. You can also go to File, Convert to, and see if it says page layout. It means you're working with word processing doc. More often than not, you will have a document with multiple sections that may require different page number formatting. Right now, all seven pages are under one section. I can tell that is the case because when I click on the thumbnails on the left, they are all highlighted. I'm going to divide our seven-page document into several sections by placing my cursor where I want a new section to start and then going to Insert and select Section Break. You can also do that by going to Menu, Insert, Section Break. I will do that for each chapter in our document. And now my document is 10 pages long. When I click on the thumbnails on the left though, I can't easily tell where each section starts and ends. I have to click on each individual image to see which pages are together. So while working on large document, I like to change the background color of each of my section to help me quickly identify where it transitions. To do that, I will go to Document, Section, Background Color. I will change the background color of each of our four sections that we created. Now let's make some modifications to each section. I will split the front matter into two pages first. Often, the page numbers for front matter in a book have a lower Roman numeral, so we will do that by selecting the page numbers and under Format, change it to Roman numerals. We want to start the book from the main title page, so I will uncheck the Match Previous section. If the next page in our document has Match Previous page turned on, its page numbering increments to the next number and uses the numbering style of the previous section. But the page shows up as page 3 and we want to start counting from 1, so we can change that under page numbering. That looks good and the rest of our document pages flow correctly. But for most books, the title page doesn't have a page number, so we will also do that by making sure we select that section in our thumbnails on the left and check the Hide on First Page of Section option under headers and footers. In some documents, you may need to skip page numbers or include a different format. We will do that in our last section for chapter 3 under page numbering. Instead of the continue from previous section option, we will select the start at radio button and start it at 10. Facing pages, also known as a two-page spread, are often used for book layouts and for double-sided documents that you intend to print. To activate facing pages, go to Document on the right, then select the Document tab and check the Facing Pages option. Now you will be able to have different headers, footers, and section layout objects on left and right facing pages. To design different page numbers on the left versus right side of your document, under section, check the left and right pages are different. Now I could have different or remove page numbers from the left side, but format it and keep it on the right side. At any time you want to remove a section or see where is the section break, you can go to Menu, View, Show Invisibles. Now you will see formatting symbols such as paragraph breaks, line breaks, section breaks, etc. It is easy to merge sections once you find the section break symbol and delete it. Page layout is often used to design flyers, newsletters, etc. You know you are in page layout because when you go to document, the document body is not checked. You can also go to File and Convert to see whether the option is to convert to word processing. In page layout, there is no body text. All text is in text boxes. There are three different ways to enter page numbers in page layout. The first way, which is the same as with word processing document, you have to hover over the header and footer areas until they become visible. Then select to insert page numbers. However, every page is treated separately here, as if it is own section. To access the options for page numbers, click on the page itself and then go to Format and under Headers and Footers, make sure the Show Headers and Footers option is checked. If you want to match the page number style to previous page, check the Match Previous Page option. And under the page numbering, you can set the format and check whether the numbering should continue from previous page or not. The second way is to edit page template by selecting it under View in the upper left corner or going to Format under Right and scrolling down to the Edit Page Template button. This is how each page will be laid out. You can insert a text box, then insert pages. You can format it and position where you want it to appear on each page. Once you're done modifying the template, click Done, and now you can see that all the pages in your document have been numbered. The last way is to create a text box and select Insert Pages from the menu. Format it as you like, then make a copy of that text box and place it anywhere you like on each page. It can be in different places. The page numbers will be updated for each page. There you go. Thanks so much for watching.